How do we conserve and protect our biodiversity while at the same time ensure a sustainable livelihood for our communities? How do we prevent pollution from our industry? And how do we combat climate change in this polarizing world? These are some of the core questions in our Bachelor, Science for Sustainable Society. My name is Thijs Bosker. I'm an associate professor in environmental sciences. Now, why come to Leiden to study science for sustainable societies? If you join us, you will be contributing to a more sustainable society and learn the skills on how to do so. You will be analyzing complex sustainability challenges from different disciplines, from both the natural and social sciences. And you will build a transferable and academic skill set that will help you for the rest of your career. There's a big difference on studying in high school and at university. In high school, it's mainly about remembering facts, while at university, it's finding facts, critically evaluating, and coming up with your own opinion on those. You often take one subject at a time in high school, while here at university, we have multiple subjects that we integrate within the same course. And then finally, in high school, it's often classroom-based, while here, of course, there is some classroom time, but we also have hands-on activities where you go in the field and where we have excursions. So we try to integrate different learning strategies. Why come to Leiden? You come to Leiden if you want to be part of a dynamic international community. We have a local to global and hands-on approach in this degree, where you learn not just to think, but also to do. And it's research-led and practice-oriented. You will be out in the field, you will be sampling ditches, you will be talking to local stakeholders. And we value interaction. So we have small-scale working groups and practicals, excursions and field trips. We get to know you. We want to interact with our students and have discussions. If this is you, that's a great match. Now, how does your program look like? First, the basics. When you come to university, you take 60 credits a year. So 60 in the first year, 60 in the second year, and then finally 60 in the third year. Importantly, after the end of the first year, we check whether you have obtained 45 credits. So this is what we call the binding study advice. If you got those, you can continue in the program. What do we value in our program? We have between 20 and 24 contact hours per week. So this means lectures, seminars, you might go on field work or do excursions. And as I mentioned before, these are often small scale classes. That means there's lots of interaction and discussion about the topics that we're discussing in class. Finally, we try to prevent one final exam at the end of your course. So we have multiple ways to evaluating you. This can be a presentation, it can be group work, writing report. So this means there's multiple ways in which you are evaluated. Some detail about the program. In your first year, you start with a course, Introduction to Science for Sustainable Societies. And this course explains to you, in a nutshell, why studying an interdisciplinary program is so important. Then you take some more disciplinary focused courses on ecology, social science methods. We also let you focus on anthropology and governance related questions. Then in your second semester, you take courses in psychology, in mathematics, earth and environment, and diversity in science. And we finish that first year by an integrative course. We bring it all together at the end of that first year in a course to show you how collaboration between these different disciplines and these courses is crucial. Moving on to your second year. There we have a mixture between integrative courses, skills and methods courses, and research design. And we finish the year with a very exciting project, a field method course, in which you will explore an issue in a real local setting. Some details about those second year courses. First, the integrative courses. So we have four integrative courses, and in these eight integrative courses, there will be co-teaching. So experts from both the social sciences and natural sciences will join you in the classroom to talk about biodiversity and livelihoods, pollution and power, sustainable food systems, and climate change and well-being. Then we will also give you some more methods, so more confidence in methods, including statistics, programming, and system modeling. And those will be integrated in courses as well, so you can practice those several times in your degree. And then we have courses on responsibility in research and innovation, so realizing that you're part of society when you do research and what your role is as a scientist. We also have a course on research design that helps to prepare you for designing your own research project. And finally, we have an integrated field course. In this field course, you go out and study a real life issue, either in the Netherlands or abroad, and you try to analyze the complexity in that field setting. Moving to your third year, you will first have the opportunity to do a 30 EC elective space. And this is very exciting. This allows you to explore your own interest, to find subjects that really interest you. I'll come back to that in a sec. And then we will move on to a sustainable societies project and a thesis research project. Okay, first that 30 EC elective space. Now, a lot of students will take a minor here at Leiden University. And there's a couple of examples here shown to my right. On top of that, you can also take a minor at another Dutch university or, very exciting, do an actual study abroad. You can visit one of our partner institutes in Australia, Canada, somewhere else in Europe, and focus on courses that interest you and that build your own program. Then you come back to us in your final semester here at Leiden University, and you start with a sustainable societies project. And this is an exciting opportunity for you to work with real local stakeholders. Doesn't have to be local, can also be global like WWF, but they have real issues they struggle with. And they will invite you with a group of your peers to address these in a very dynamic and interactive research project. And you will practice collaborating and project management during these types of projects. And then you move on to your own project, your thesis research project. Here you start doing research by yourself on a topic that you're passionate about. Of course, there will be supervision. You work with a group of other students that help you to fine-tune your research, but you're also supervised by experienced staff members to make sure that you will excel in this final step of your degree. Now, with all this, you learn a range of different skills. You learn to critically think and integrate insights. You learn how to collaborate and how to do project management, how to present, discuss, and write reports. You will learn how to analyze data. You learn how to program and how you do modeling, but also field work. And this means chasing after birds, but also interviewing people on the complexity of current sustainability issues. Now, what will you do after you completed your degree with us? There's multiple options, but most of you will continue in doing a master program. Now, there's several master programs that are on offer here at Leiden University. For example, Governance of Sustainability and Industrial Ecology, which are also highly interdisciplinary programs. You could also decide to do a more disciplinary-based program. For example, Biodiversity and Sustainability or Cultural Anthropology and Developmental Sociology. And of course, you can also find an MSc program at any other Dutch university or abroad. Plenty of opportunities. Now, what type of jobs do you go into once you're done? There's many options. Here are some. You can become a consultant of a public or private organization. You can start becoming a policy advisor at a governmental organization or a strategic advisor at a company. And you can continue in doing research, for example, at a university or a research institute. Now, is this program for you? That's a very important question to ask yourself. I can tell you what we are looking for. We're looking for students that want to work towards a more sustainable society. Students that like to be challenged, that want to integrate both knowledge from the natural and social sciences, that want to learn key transferable skills and specific methods that they can apply in their future careers. So we're looking for students that are not afraid to challenge themselves, that are willing to be pushed out of their comfort zone, and that want to work on these highly complex but fascinating questions with us. Now, some very important questions. How to apply to our program and what are the admission requirements? First, the admission requirements. You need to obtain a Dutch VBO diploma or an international equivalent. And you have to have taken mathematics and 2 out of the following 5 subjects. You can see them here on the screen. There is always more information available on our website. We also have what we call a compulsory matching module. Now, what does that mean? We want to make sure that you are a good match with our program. We want to allow you to explore what we will be doing during your degree. So we've developed some material in which you can try some of the content that you will be covering in our program. And this allows you to get a good feeling of what we aim to do within our program. Again, more information can be found on our website. Now, once you've decided that this is the program for you, the actual dates for application can be found on our website or are seen here next to me. Finally, it's a big transition going to university from high school. Many of you will live on your own for the first time, and some of you might move from abroad. And that means we value good support. So we have a mentoring system. We have excellent study advisors that guide you in the first steps onto university. We also have student psychologists for those students that seek help. We have support when studying with a disability. And finally, we have several diversity and inclusion student networks in which you can join and participate. Now, I hope you've become excited about this program. So, where to get some more information? Of course, you can go to our website, but we've also organized some different activities. We have open days. We have student for a day opportunities, either online or offline. And you can meet with a study advisor who can give you some more information about our program. I've been talking a lot and I've been explaining about the program in quite a bit of detail, but of course, more information can be found on our website. With this, I want to finish off by stating we'd like to welcome you to our program. We want to welcome students that want to make a difference. It's an exciting field to work in. There's many opportunities, and we hope to see you in our classroom to focus and work on these issues together with us.